So welcome to another session on design of machine elements. In today's lecture, we'll see how to design a brake. Brakes are devices that dissipate kinetic energy of the moving parts of a machine. In mechanical brakes, the dissipation is achieved through the sliding friction between a stationary object and a rotating part. Depending on the construction, they are classified as shoe brake, band brake, disc brake. First, we'll see what is a shoe brake. In a shoe brake, there will be a drum which is brought to rest by applying the frictional force through a shoe. The contacting force of the shoe is coated with a friction material, and further, the shoe brakes are classified as single shoe brake, double shoe brake, and internal expanding shoe brake. First, we'll see the design of a single shoe brake. A single shoe brake consists of a lever, so there is a lever on which a shoe is fixed. This shoe will be having the friction material. The lever will be attached on a fulcrum, so there is a hinge point on the left end. So when we apply the braking force, here we have the braking force applied at the right end. So when we apply a force in the downward direction, the shoe presses the drum downwards, and the friction material comes into contact with the drum and it is brought to rest. For the analysis, we consider forces, normal force and friction force. Normal force is denoted by Fn, and friction force is denoted by mu Fn, where mu is the coefficient of friction coefficient. Now we'll see how to find all these forces, Fn and mu Fn. For that, we consider the free body diagram. When we apply a force at the end of the lever, that force is denoted by P. It is applying downwards, acting downwards. So the shoe will be moving downwards. The shoe will be exerting a force on the drum that will be acting downward direction. Since it is normal to the circle, it is denoted by N. So the drum will be exerting a same normal reaction in the upward direction, both equal to N. Now consider the rotation of the drum. Here, the drum is rotating in clockwise direction. So the friction force on the drum should be acting opposite to rotation. So it should be acting opposite rotation, that is mu n acting towards left side. Further, acting on the same point on the shoe, the friction force should act opposite to what is the friction force on the drum. So friction force on the shoe will be acting towards right. So all these forces get cancelled out, they are in equilibrium. Now we see how to use these values